When you connect your laptop to a new Wi-Fi network, it's never enough for Windows to just connect you and be done with it. It always asks you this rather cryptic question about whether you want your PC to be discoverable on the network, with a warning that you shouldn't do it if you're sitting at a Starbucks or something. But many folks have never quite understood what picking one option over the other one means. And even more frustrating is that if you click the wrong thing or click away from it, it's very difficult to find that prompt again. So basically what it comes down to is whether you want to use file and device sharing, for devices it would commonly be something like a printer, on your local network. And lots of people never bother with this, but it can be useful. So let's have a look at what answering that question yes or no actually does, and how to take advantage of the associated features. If you tell Windows that you don't want your computer to be discoverable, it won't let any other devices on the network see any files or devices that you're sharing either. And this is simply meant as another layer of protection if you're on a strange network, like one at an airport, library, or a Tinder date's apartment who you just met like an hour ago. But if you answer yes, it will allow you to share those things on whatever network you're connected to. So how do you get that set up? Well, unfortunately, Windows doesn't make it super obvious, and the Home Group feature that was meant to make file sharing a bit more straightforward was axed in Windows 10 because, ironically, nobody used it. The easiest way to share things locally is to create a folder containing everything that you'd like your friends or roommates or whoever to have access to. And you can do this after creating and filling up the folder by right-clicking on it, then going Give Access To, then selecting specific people. You'll see a menu pop up, and in that drop-down box, you can select everyone if you just want to share that folder broadly with everyone on your local network. Though it's very important to be sure to select what permission level you'd like to give other users. You can select read if you don't want anyone modifying the files, like if you're sharing a game cache or something. Then all you need to do is click share, and you'll be given a path to send to the other users on your network. Just have them type it into the File Explorer address bar, and voila! Your files are now available network-wide. If instead you only want to share with certain people, you can make another user account on your computer with a password, and then type that username into the box in the sharing window. Then you can give those credentials to whomever you want to have access to the files, and when they access the appropriate path, they'll be asked to enter them. But what about sharing a printer? This is actually a little more straightforward, even if the setting itself is buried a little bit. Go to your main Windows 10 Settings app, select Devices, then Printers and Scanners. Whichever printer is connected to your local PC should pop up. You just select it and click on Manage. Now, annoyingly, you don't get a nice big button that says Share. So instead, you need to click on Printer Properties, and in the box that pops up, you should see a tab up top labeled Sharing. Click it, then check the box that says Share This Printer. Give it a funny name or just anything that people on your network will recognize, then click OK. Now, as long as the host computer is turned on, anyone on the network should be able to add the printer from that same Printers and Scanners menu by clicking The Printer I Want Isn't Listed, then entering the path in this format or just browsing for it. Now I know that there are more advanced and more secure ways to share files and printers across a network, which I'm sure our viewers will be happy to discuss in the comments. But hopefully this guide has demystified the topic a bit and will help get you up and running. As for me, I'm not gonna bother because I never learned to share as a kid, and besides, printer ink is expensive. Who wrote that ending joke? What's not a joke is our sponsor. If you're a student, a professional, or just someone who wants to understand the world better, check out Brilliant. Brilliant is the website that helps you reach your learning goals by working just a little bit on it every day. They offer interactive explorations, and their mobile app will help you master concepts in math, science, and computer science by taking complex concepts and breaking them down into bite-sized chunks. Over time, you will be amazed by what you can accomplish. We suggest checking out their Mathematical Fundamentals course, which has been redesigned with interactive features to help you with the foundational concepts behind algebra, number theory, and logic, making it a great resource for STEM students. The first 200 of you who are going to head to brilliant.org/techquickie are going to get 20% off their annual premium subscription too. So don't wait, go check them out at the link in the video description. Thanks for watching, guys. Like, dislike, check out our other videos. Leave a comment if you have a suggestion for a future Fast As Possible. And don't forget to subscribe and follow, because if you don't do it, then fleas will bite your toes while you sleep. And nobody wants that. Especially.